Albert Fish comes out, and then shortly after, we'll have a female fan of the band come out, take the stick away from him, and proceed to beat him up on stage throughout the remainder of the song.
People talk about serial killer culture, and what they don't understand is that's American culture.
I got more and more practiced, versed at what I was doing and how I was going to ask for what I wanted in the long run, which was art.
People actually come from everywhere for this tour.
Remember when we did that open mic at that Christian coffee house?
That's right. They loved us.
They did. They were all left. They were like, well, you guys are singing about Satan, but you guys are pretty good. It was entertaining.
I like it more about the psychology of why someone would do this rather than be fascinated of why these crimes have happened.
Our inspiration for the song Mr. Fish was actually from a documentary we saw.
This painting is the pivotal piece of the Manson series. It's called Helter Skelter.
I came across the story of Chicago's murder castle, and it was the story of Dr. H.H. Holmes.
I was reading a book about Richard Ramirez, and in the book it said he spent his spare time writing to people on the outside. I was like, yeah, that'd be pretty cool to try.
Gacy sent me this card for, you know, my mother's death.
Pretty much if you can name any popular killer who's well known, we probably have a song about him.
My personal opinion about these type of things is that they are actual historical artifacts.
The people that really glorify murderers and bad guys and serial killers, these are the guys that are at the top of the heap.
They got me interested in it, they got you interested in it, and they got all of the world interested in the grisly, macabre actions of these weirdos.